for that dark colored car, and they want everyone to be alert.
We think this is probably an isolated incident. We don't think it's just a random act. So we don't think that the public at large is in danger. But you should always be aware of your surroundings and those that are in it.
Police say Palouche has been released from the hospital last check. Just before the shooting, but they're not sure that had anything to do with it. Kentucky State says it's doing its own investigation. Reporting live in the studio, Melanie Kendall, ABC 36 News.
All right, Melanie, thank you. Listen to this story out of Baltimore County. Deputies say a woman told them she didn't hear or see a train coming when she crossed the tracks. And I'm going to show you what her car looked like after the CSX freight train hit it. It happened on Hazel Patch Road just north of London. 63-year-old Annetta Conley and her 37-year-old daughter, who was in the car with her, went to the hospital for their injuries.
Oh, what a great day to be outside. Mild temperatures once again. However, we've had more clouds building back in this afternoon, and a couple of rain showers beginning to show on live HD radar right now. Most of that activity right along central Kentucky, from Louisville to Georgetown, Louisiana, Paris, Carlisle, over to Williamsburg and Maine. Rain showers around you, as well as Frankfort, right around the Lexington metro area. Areas just south of I-64, the same for you, from Nicholasville to Danville, Lebanon, Middleburg, Mount Vernon, all seeing some light rain showers right now. Jamestown, over to Williamsburg, you got some spotty rainfall. So these rain showers will stay around for the next little while. We'll see some more widespread rain developing as we go into your overnight average. The 6 hour time lapse shows the clouds moving back in this afternoon. It was nice earlier today when we had a little bit more sunshine along with our temperatures. Temperatures that have been out there today again back into the 60s, 61 currently for Washington, Frankfort, and Danville. We've got lower 60s from Danville to Somerset to mid 60s right now for Jackson, London, and Corbin at 66 degrees. Your wind speeds right now anywhere from about 5 to 10 miles per hour. At times we've had some wind speeds up around 15 miles per hour. Give us a little breezy conditions this afternoon. Evening planner shows temperatures fall into the mid-50s around 8 o'clock, 48 degrees around the midnight hour. Again, just a few rain showers possible throughout the evening. Better chance for more widespread rain overnight, though. And as we head into your Thursday, we'll have details on that and much colder temperatures in the forecast here in just a few minutes. Tom?
Thank you, Jason. Time for your nation view. A judge has declared a mistrial in the case of a Baltimore City police officer, William Porter. He was the first officer to face trial on the death of Freddie Gray. According to court documents, Gray died from injuries occurred when he was in police custody. The mistrial came after the jurors said they were hopelessly deadlocked and couldn't reach a unanimous verdict on any of the four charges against Officer Porter, including involuntary manslaughter. A new trial date will have to be set. Five other Baltimore City police officers still face charges for Gray's death from last April.
I guess we're going to go eat before we go.
The Federal Reserve today raised the
interest
rate for the first time since 2006. That increase, of course, is going to impact home loans, credit cards, and the stock market. Steve Mattis has the latest from Washington, D.C.